Good morning, PASW staff, clients, and friends joining us. Welcome to Friday's class. I mean, thank God it's Friday, right? We've had a tough week. We really have, academically and class-wise and, you know, socially too. But let's focus on music and art. That's perhaps is the only thing that can really save us. Art. So today is going to be the film scoring challenge results. I gave you guys an extra, you know, week or so, because I figured the weekend maybe wasn't enough time, and it wasn't good planning on my part, so I'm sorry about that. But today I'm going to show you the results of all of your guys' very cool, fun. I got some very, very cool stuff from you guys, so everyone did a great job. And again, there's no right or wrong answer for any of these things. I think we'll do more of these because it's fun. Especially in particular, like scenes like this, because it could go either way, you know? Let's show the scene. Let's show the assignment just so everyone's on the same page. This is the assignment that I gave you. This has no score in it. I removed the score, so you just hear sound of the desert. So this is a clip from 1962 Lawrence of Arabia. Now let's listen to some of your guys's. I put your name, I give you guys credit underneath, so let's take a listen to what you guys came up with. It's funny because with John's, it matched perfectly. I don't know if he meant it, but I literally, when he said start at 4:57, I started there and I didn't change the music at all. It's almost like he knew frame by frame. Sometimes it's just a happy coincidence, but it's like magical and cool when the scene changes and the music changes. You know, I mean, composers can spend, less so today, but back, you know, in the 20s, 30s, 40s, when they were scoring music before computers, I mean, you know, we can do a class on that with the SMPTE time code. You know, you would have to rewrite manuscripts and of music, of adding a rest. We need a rest here because the whole picture's off and there's going to be silence here for 2 seconds if we don't put a rest. So we need to change all the cello parts, make sure the cellos have a rest. The cellos do? Okay. Oh, wait, did you put the trump, make sure the trumpets have a rest? Otherwise they're going to come in. I mean, it's chaos. It still is, but I mean, I think it's with computers, it makes it easier. So I love how John's just fit, you know, perfectly. Okay. So, you know, I think as a teacher and friend, colleague with you, I decided to do my own. So see what you think of this. So that last one was kind of a joke, but it could be used seriously, right? So let's review them. So we started with Matthew Payne's original score. So he wrote that, I believe, in GarageBand, which I'm so impressed. I love the organ sound. It's very eerie. It reminds me kind of a Kubrick film with, you know, score, kind of like a kind of this droney score that you don't know what's going to happen, something frightening. That was great, and he wrote that, I mean, like, I'm probably less than an hour, because he emailed it to me right away. So, good job, Matthew. So proud of you. I think it works beautifully in that. So, and then with Sarah's, now we have kind of, with the Bruckner Symphony, a more romantic kind of, you know, it could be like a Out of Africa, like kind of love story, like lush and romantic, and, you know, the complete opposite of Matthew Payne's, where it's like it's Out of Africa or it's like, you know, The Shining. Something weird, something bad's going to happen with Matthew. Something with Sarah, at least to me, this is all subjective. At least with Sarah, this is going to be a romantic desert trip, perhaps, or something like that. Mark Pulver did the route of just having atmospheric desert sounds, which is very nice. You know, we've talked in class before how sometimes having no music and just sounds can be really effective, sometimes more effective. With Psycho, when the strings start, it's very scary. But when there's no music and it's just her expression, that's really scary too. So Mark did a great job of just, because when you don't hear music and you just hear sounds, it's uncomfortable for the audience because you have to create the scene, the emotion in the scene. And when there's no music dictating that, then that's scary. If I was in a desert and just heard sounds, especially at night, I'd be terrified. If I heard Bruckner's score, I'd be like, well, isn't this such a romantic time? If I heard Matthew Payne's score, I'd be like, I think I need to run as fast as I can out of here, you know? So it's like all these different emotions. And we talked about John's score, how that worked beautifully. The moody blues worked so great. And the timing of it, I guess, I don't know how he got that so right. But that, That sounds, that score just was so, I mean, Moody Blues were such a great band, and we should talk more about them at some point, because they were kind of a rock band, but kind of went into way more interesting areas, too. And then, yeah, I wasn't sure which one to choose, so I wanted to choose The Saber Dance by Kachatorian, which is hilarious. So with mine, what did it look like? They were going to a circus, maybe? This was a silly comedy. This was like a Mel Brooks, Blazing Saddles thing. All of these issued different responses, different emotions. And I know we always talk about how film music can change or, you know, make the movie. But this was cool because this was your guys' assignment. And you, I think we should do this again because I love, everybody's is different. One's funny, one's terrifying, one's romantic, one is film score-like, which is kind of, we'll hear the original one, but I think, you know, it's like, it's really cool. It's just one's, it's the same scene, but the movie could go an entirely different direction because we don't, you know, we only have this minute to score. So, great job, great work, everybody. So proud of you. If you do like this, I think we should do it again and pick a scene where there's many interpretations, you know, instead of like Jaws, because we all know that that's kind of scary. But I don't know. I'll think of some other scenes. So proud of you. Excellent job, everybody. Just so cool. Thank you for sending those to me. Thank you for doing the homework assignment. I really appreciate it. Okay, so... Oh, and I'm sorry, I forgot. I was going to end with showing you the original score. Sorry about that. By Maurice Jarre, French composer. So this is the music that ended up happening for the film Lawrence of Arabia. And like, you know, like I said, there's no right answers. All your guys' music would have fit perfectly. It would have gone in a different direction. So it's always up to the director of what kind of score he wants, because it's his vision, and the composer has to accommodate that. So, okay, let's watch the original score to Lawrence of Arabia, and have a great weekend. I'll see you soon.